Hello friends, welcome back to another episode by Engineering Today, and we'll start with a Starship update today. Well, Starship S-24 and Super Heavy Booster 7 may be the company's primary attention as they get ready for their conceivably upcoming orbital launch debuts. The rest of the Starship manufacturing isn't just sitting around. Starbase's ability to generate rockets may have been hindered by the factory's laser focus on thoroughly testing Ship 24 and Booster 7, but it has nevertheless continued to produce new ships and boosters. A pair of prototypes expected to follow in the footsteps of S-24 and B-7 have even undergone some limited testing by SpaceX. When Starship S-25 was moved by SpaceX from the factory to the launch pad in mid-January, that procedure entered a new and busier stage. Ship 25 has traveled before. On October 19, 2022, not longer after the ship had been completely built, Starship S-25 made its way to SpaceX's South Texas launch and testing facilities. Testing continued for about 3 weeks, and now Ship 25 is back for more. The initial series of tests was exhaustive and included a pneumatic proof test, numerous cryogenic proof tests, and maybe a few simulated thrust tests employing 6 hydraulic rams for Ship 25. As per usual, SpaceX declined to comment on the news or provide information about the results of the initial proof testing. But Ship 25's return to the launch pad on January 14, 2023, almost made it certain that everything had gone relatively according to plan. Ship 25 proof testing went according to schedule, as demonstrated by the fact that on January 17th, SpaceX lifted Ship 25 onto Starbase's Sol Starship static fire test platform. 6 Raptor engines were carried into the high bay and placed on Ship 25 shortly after its November 2022 return to Starbase's construction site. Before heading to the test site to start its static fire test campaign, the Starship's aft was most likely sealed off with a heat shield. We might learn a lot about the state of the Starship prototypes from that campaign. Only 2 ships have conducted full 6 Raptor static fire tests yet, and both took days, weeks, or months to build up to those 6 engine milestones with a number of smaller tests. It would be a hint that SpaceX is far more confident in the new Starship design if Ship 25 were to forego those preliminary tests and undertake a 6 engine static fire test right away. It's thought that Super Heavy Booster 9, which just completed its own series of proving testing, will be partnered with Ship 25. Booster 9 left the Starbase assembly bay on December 15, 2022, about 2 months after Ship 25, and moved toward the launch pad. In the end, the Super Heavy prototype underwent 2 partial cryogenic proof tests on December 21st and 29th, when it was probably loaded with almost 1,000 tons of liquid nitrogen to imitate explosive liquid oxygen and methane fuel. Then, on January 10, 2023, Booster 9 went back to the Starbase factory. Raptor engine installation might start at any time, assuming the tests were successful. It can take longer than normal to outfit and test this Super Heavy because of the major design changes and enhancements available on Booster 9. The addition of an improved Raptor is by far the most important alteration among many minor ones. The combustion-related hardware of the engine is probably identical to that of the Raptor V2 engines seen on Booster 7, Ship 24, and Ship 25. Thrust Vector Control, TVC, the hardware that steers each engine, has undergone a significant upgrade. Booster 9's 13 central Raptors will be electrically guided rather than employing a complicated network of plumbing and hydraulic power units mounted to the side of Super Heavy. This has made it possible for SpaceX to eliminate those power units, streamlining the exterior of Booster 9, and to simplify the piping system that's already necessary to fuel, operate, regulate, and steer a large number of high-performance rocket engines on a single booster. In order to make sure that all 13 electrically steered engines function well together before, during, and after several static fire tests, Booster 9 will likely be thoroughly tested after all 33 engines are mounted. Additionally, SpaceX will need to confirm the proper operation of the batteries that are probably powering those new technologies. The electric TVC may have to quickly reroute more than 3,000 tons, about 6.6 million pound force of thrust, several times per second during the peak pressures they would probably experience. As a result, Super Heavy's batteries will probably need to provide enormous peak power. Super Heavy B9's static fire test campaign won't begin until Booster 7, Ship 24, and Starship's initial orbital launch campaign have finished using Starbase's lone orbital launch mount, which could take several months at this point. Booster 9 has plenty of time to unwind inside Starbase's wide bay, while Ship 25 starts static fire testing at a different stand because that orbital launch debut is unlikely to occur before March of 2023. Our second and last update will cover SpaceX launches advanced GPS satellite for US Space Force. Nails the landing. On Wednesday, January 18th, at 7:24 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, that's 12:24 Greenwich Mean Time, SpaceX's Falcon 9 rocket blasted off from Florida's Cape Canaveral Space Force Station carrying a brand new GPS satellite. An upgraded Falcon 9 first stage booster was used to launch the Global Positioning Satellite. This booster had previously launched the International Space Station Crew 5 astronauts Nicole Mann and John Quesada of NASA, Koichi Wakata of Japan, and Anna Kakina of Russia. The first stage safely dropped back to Earth and landed on SpaceX's drone ship called a Shortfall of Gravitas around 8 minutes and 40 seconds after cleanly separating from the payload-carrying upper stage at Space Launch Complex 40 at Cape Canaveral, Florida. In the launch livestream, SpaceX said that the fairing, which shielded the cargo during the initial ascent of the rocket, would be recovered from the Atlantic Ocean for potential future reuse. After delivering the payload to a height of roughly 2,670 miles, or 4,300 kilometers, above the planet's surface, the upper stage released the satellite around 1 hour and 30 minutes after takeoff. The satellite, dubbed Amelia Earhart, after the illustrious female pilot, and the first woman to successfully fly across the Atlantic Ocean, will now continue on its own to reach its operational orbit 12,500 miles, or 20,200 kilometers, above our planet. Amelia Earhart is the sixth satellite in the series. The American Space Force, which owns and manages the satellite, is attempting to update the nation's GPS fleet as a whole. According to its manufacturer, Lockheed Martin, the new satellite has a 15-year projected lifespan and will eventually be included in a group of 32 next-generation satellites. The most recent generation of GPS satellites has up to 3 times greater accuracy, 8 times better anti-jamming systems, and a new modular design for adaptations, according to Lockheed Martin. These improvements help the spacecraft better address changing mission needs and emerging threats. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting. And kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.